guys, and we're sure what we're doing. Like I said in the first, didn't say in the second, I'm poorly today. So I might do a few coughs. There, that's why I'm in creative. You can either do that or make that jump, which isn't possible to, or I don't know, even don't even know why I said make. Well, like do. Try. Yeah, try. And also a mineshaft. A mineshaft in a stronghold. Remember when the fences were like this? Not. We just got to the fence jumps and it's getting super tricky. Look at it. Ah! When I say extremely hard to collect, this took over 3 hours and 5 diamond swords to get to level 46. Oh yeah, and another thing, in this version, if you pick a level 46 enchantment, it doesn't just take off a few levels like today's versions, no. It takes you back down to level 0. I literally have one shot at this, otherwise I'm doing that again for the next 3 hours. The only good thing about this in this version is that you can just refresh like this. You don't have to make an enchantment to refresh it, you just keep clicking. But I haven't seen a level 46 enchantment anywhere. I think the most I've found is 34, so maybe I'll add some more books. And that is also not working. Okay, I've been refreshing for like 15 minutes now, and now I can't even find a 34. So if I see a 32, I'm going for it. 32, please. And this is what depression looks like. Okie dokie, now 8 diamond swords down, and we're at level 36. I'm taking a risk here, but I'm going for it. I can feel it this time. This is the one. I know it. Oh, 34. Do I go? I'll go for 34. Please. Visible happiness. Okay, here we go. We're going to choose this one. Please break. There we are. Monster spawner. Monster spawner acquired. I wonder what happens if I place it. This is just a tricky jump if you want to slime.
I can't risk losing it, but in this version there's a different way to do. Okay, so we've got a setup like this, and then we're going to light the portal, and then place the water there, and that's not supposed to happen. So, okay, so, alright. Am I stacking water? I'm stacking water. Okay, I guess you can stack water in this update. Okay, so place it there. Yes, that works. And then another one there. Now we light it, and we put a crafting table there. Grab the monster spawner. Now as we push through the portal by the water, we place the spawner in the crafting table, and there we are. There are two monster spawners. But one of them is very interesting. When we pick up this one and try and place it, it just spawns more monster spawners. So we can do this forever. There we go. We can just do this forever. And this broken spawner will even eat other spawners. So I'd say that...
Now... Okay, I'm going to finish it, and I'm not going to show you. I'm just kidding, I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you how to build the perfect one. So look at this. It's a prison escape. Going to build a, like a room there and everywhere else. But for now, just doing this and testing it. What I'm going to do next is... One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Then 12.
Creative mode. That's right. Creative mode in hardcore.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
This weird looking creeper spawner. I mean, technically it's legit, right? I mean, I got given creative mode. I mean surely I can't do it. It's cheating. Anyway, I thought that was just a fun little thing. On to the next update. Okay, we're now in 1.3.1 and we're here for one thing. If you're wondering why I'm getting ice, all will be revealed. And as you can see, by this version, end portals are looking a lot more like end portals. Alright, update time. And we're dying. Haha, I'm in the floor. Why am I in the floor? Okay, so I said update time, but really I meant downgrade time. Because now we're back in 1.2.5. Why? Well, you'll see. Oh good, this is a lovely nether spawn. Yeah, nothing dangerous about this. Ferner had some water here. Then I could swim down. Oh, look, how convenient. How convenient, there's water here. And apparently it doesn't break your fall. Okay, noted. This is so wrong. This is wrong on so many levels. Yeah, just casually making an obsidian bridge over this lava lake. Nothing to see here. I just can't stop placing water. It just feels so wrong. It looks so wrong. There's some water. Oh,
and here.
Isn't it? It feels so good. And you already know.
I'm going to make it underneath the map so that whenever a person goes there, there will be a guard slash few zombies and then some parkour thing. Someone to shoot for lasers. And then I'm just going to Sunday today.
Okay, now we can make a carrot on a stick. Now all Sunday. These pigs are going to flock to me, but that's the biggest mistake that they could make. Why? Well, because I'm going to put sharpness 5 on it. Sharpness 5, carrot on a stick. Yeah, you guys might want to stop following me. You really might want to stop following me now. I actually really underestimate how overpowered sharpness 5, carrot on a stick is. This thing is powerful. Totally worth it. Okay, now we're going stupid. We've got a knockback 2, and we're going to put a knockback 2 on a piece of dirt. It's knockback 2 dirt. Knockback 2 dirt. Look, pigs, it's knockback 2 dirt. Okay, there we are. We've got a sharpness 5 carrot on a stick, and a knockback 2 dirt. Actually, I'm going to keep the sharpness 5 carrot on a stick, because that's actually, I'm not kidding, my most powerful weapon I have right now. And the last thing we're going to do in this version is make a nameless diamond. We've got no name. Okay, there we are. Time to update. Okay, I'm nowhere. This and we are here to get bedrock. That's right, we're going to attempt to get bedrock, and this is also the combat update, which means my carrot on a stick is no longer my most powerful weapon. R.I.P. carrot on a stick. Why did I spawn down here? I swear this world is just absolutely falling apart now. And it's also the update that introduced lapis to the enchantment process. Man, Minecraft used to be so much better. I just found half a door, I guess. It's half a door. Yeah, this world is literally falling apart. And this furnace is broken as well. It's a broken furnace. And we can no longer click refresh, so we're going to have to make a lot more enchantments now. Yeah, that'll do. And we'll also make this. We need to collect some gas tears, and some blaze rods, and ender pearls. Go away. What? What do you mean? What do you mean there's a chicken attacking me? Why is there a chicken attacking me? No. Look, it's not even that there's something riding me. Hit it. There's nothing. It's just an angry chicken. I'm sorry, but I can't allow you to live. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna destroy all the evidence. This world is becoming more and more broken with each passing minute. Okay, now we can make the end crystals, and we're getting closer and closer. Just need a few more resources. Okay, since we have end portal frames, we can just put the portal wherever we like, and I think it'd be pretty funny to do it in here. Okay, brilliant.
Try doing things like this.
Get some water and collect some arrows.
Three more blocks. Two more once I've done this. Well, what I mean is taking away is not blocks.
Hold up. Why does he
blocks
just die
push
like that?
One bit.
Cool, so now we're going to try and get this this egg to go through the portal, and of course it didn't. Okay, we'll also just throw some things through, and then that should tell
us. Let's see, what is like laser? Can go on the side.
We need to mark this point, just like that. And no, I'm not trying to summon Hero Brian, but before we do that, we need to enchant some better armor real quick. Also, I just realised, there's only usually one dragon egg in each world, right? Which means, technically, that's illegal. Okay, it's not the best, but it's a bit of protection, so that should be fine. Right, grab everything we need, and let's go. Okay, so the idea is that once we place this end crystal in the middle, it will replace the bedrock above.
No, let's just make
left click, so it explodes. And because the summon process has been interrupted, it should have glitched the bedrock that replaced with the end crystal.
Way.
To the world spawn. maybe. But the chances that worked first time, very slim. This is going to be the longest run of my life. It actually worked first time. That is a block of bedrock in survival. I mean, I know this process worked, but I didn't think it would actually work. I'm so happy that worked first time. We don't have to spend ages getting more materials for more end crystals. And there she is, the final piece to our collection. So now we're going to take it all and put it in the nether. Why? The future Kalani will explain. You see, you can transfer items from one world to another through the nether world. The way to do this is you place your items that you want to move in a chest. Write down the coordinates, then go into your Minecraft folder and copy that nether world and paste it into your other world. When you go into the nether, it will look exactly the same as it did before. But if you travel to the coordinates that you wrote down, you'll find that you've merged the two nether worlds into one, and your chest full of items is sat there waiting for you. Now you just grab them, go back home, replace your nether world back to the original, and boom, you've transferred your items. And hopefully haven't corrupted your world, but nah, I'm sure that won't happen, don't worry. Okie dokie, I think I've put my items here. I'll cover it up.
Now push reply, I think. Stone is the best.
You may have to trample over your dead friends to escape, but you can escape. Yeah, there we go. It's like, this is what it looks like. Yeah, buddy, this is what it looks like up here. This is your life now. Alrighty, time to burn everything to the ground. I love how he's still up there having some sort of crisis. Why towers? Why, I guess. Alright, here we go. Going back home. Ah, home. That was wild. Yes, my items. Oh, thank you. Yes, come here. Okay, time to find out if it works. Okay, yes, this is literally just my nether. It just looks like my nether, but without my buildings. So, if we travel to these coordinates, we should find the chest. I just think it's going to involve a lot of this. Alright, this looks like old nether terrain, and I'm lagging like crazy, so I think we're getting close. Oh, the water's still here. Okay, that is very interesting. I thought the water would disappear, right? I can't believe my water base is still here. And it's all there. All right, we've grabbed our items. Let's get out of here. Okay, next item on our list isn't really an item. It's a backwards nether portal, otherwise known as a pether portal. But for this to work, we need to update the suppressor machine. So we're going to need a lot of gold. It's time to speedrun a gold farm. Okay, they should be coming through any moment now. Brilliant. I think that's enough gold. Okay, so now we've made all the rails, and that should be enough, I think. I hope. Now we just need a place to build this thing, but it needs to face west. Okay, facing west. How about here, on the side of the mountain? Let's build our illegal museum here. Okey-dokey, let's hollow out an area. Okay, so let's make like a circle. Like that, love a good circle, and this is where our pether portal is going to be, right there. Which means that
really, then we put this some redstone like that. We draw.
Okay, we've got a basic area for the machine. Yes.
Okay. Here we go. Yep. Now iron.
Okay, now it's connecting down to the portal. Now it's
doors.
Okay, I mean, it's moving. This was without a doubt the biggest headache of my life, and I still don't even know. Yeah, I haven't tested it. There she is. So yeah, if this looks complicated to you, that'll just be because it is. There's what's hopefully going to happen when we turn this machine on, is that we're going to be able to start breaking the obsidian around the portal without the portal breaking. So first off, the bottom layer will break, that's fine, we want that to happen. And then we'll be left with this shape, then we hollow out the middle, place it with obsidian, and boom, pether portal. Listen, I'm not very good at explaining things, you'll see what I mean. But first, let's just double check that this actually works. We're going to place this here, and a rail on top. So we put the piston down, press that, something happens, that should mean it's on. Now if this makes a noise, it means it's not worked. Okay, I think I may have found the problem. You were supposed to be a sticky piston. Alright, let's try this again.
Let me test it.
Hopefully this doesn't make a noise. Aha! Now I'm going to break this block below and hopefully this shouldn't break.
With a lever.
What? Okay, it worked for a second and just stopped working. Now it's not working. Why is it not working? Okay, that's working. So hopefully this should work.
I think I know what's wrong.
And this one, first layer done, but it's, yeah, this bottom layer was supposed to break. Now, hopefully, nothing else should break. That's
this is super low.
And we're going to move this whole section behind the portal up one block. Second layer. Easy, right?